Hey, what's up? It's Johnny Mosley kicking it here with none other than Cyrus on the extreme scene, man.
Winner X gold medalist just won the gold medal in the Superpipe contest just about 2 months back. She's an Aussie, straight from Ausland, Tori Bride. Tora, how are you doing?
I'm doing very well.
Beautiful. Excellent, excellent. Now, I think this is the obvious question, and I'm not the sharpest guy, so I always go for the low-hanging fruit. How do you end up becoming a professional snowboarder hailing from the land of perfect surf?
Yes.
I get that question a lot.
I know. I told you. I wasn't very original. It's the low-hanging fruit, but that's as tall as I can reach.
It's early in the interview, though, so we'll get deeper.
I'll get much deeper.
Okay.
Well, Cyrus might.
Yeah.
I'm shy.
Well, I come from, we have mountains in Australia, and where I live is like really close to the mountains, so closer to the mountains than the surf. So.
Now, where do you hail from in Australia?
It's a little town called Cooma, and it's about an hour and a half south of Canberra, which is the capital.
Divulge what the snow situation is like in Australia, because I guarantee nobody knows.
I don't. Okay.
Yeah.
So we only have snow on like the southeast coast, and it's, way down in Australia, in New South Wales and Victoria, like just bordering the state line there. And, I mean, the snow, we have snow for about 3 months of the year, and we don't get that much.
3 months? You only have snow for 3 months?
Yep. And
wow.
It's pretty much spring all year round, except for the occasional, 2 centimeter powder day we'll get.
The 2 centimeter, wow, blowing up.
yeah. But I have to admit, I've had some of the funnest days riding ever in Australia.
Everybody who is a pro snowboarder, pretty much, everybody we've spoken to, learned on crap. Like, they were forced to learn on ice and slush and just pure low-altitude crap. And I'm starting to wonder, it really never occurred to me before, but is that what makes you guys so good? Because you have to learn on this crap?
Because you have to excel in the worst conditions.
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure. I reckon learning on, soft, slushy, crap snow is probably the best. Because you'll maybe take more chances with learning,
Right.
So, yeah, I don't know. That's interesting. You can ride crap. You can pretty much ride anything.
That's true. And I think you just hit the nail on the head with that one.
Yeah.
I think that's it.
Tora Bryant is here on the Extreme Scene Olympic, or not Olympic, Winter X Games gold medalist. You actually compete in the Olympics too, is that correct?
I did.
How'd
in the
do?
Olympics, you were what, fifth?
Yeah, I came fifth in the Olympics.
At first glance, I would never even imagine Australia having really Winter Olympic representatives.
They're huge on the bobsled.
Okay. Yeah, what?
And luge. Yeah.
that'd be my... Sorry.
We actually had, there were 2 girls for the half pipe and then 3 guys for the half pipe in snowboarding. So
wow.
We actually had a pretty decent team. So, yeah, I don't know. The experience was incredible. And wearing a uniform was the best part for me, for sure.
What? Oh, really?
We had the gold and green, striped tracksuits, and it was pretty awesome.
Nice.
Yeah, that is pretty cool.
Yeah, you guys, I actually think Australia probably has a much cooler, Olympic uniforms. They don't have to wear the whole American flag thing, which just seems a little gaudy to me, but...
Yeah, I don't know. Australia could definitely do some good stuff with, the boxing kangaroo or something.
See? And you guys have one of my favorite animals over in Australia, the wombat.
The wombat. They are pretty good.
They're awesome. There's these big, giant, digging rats.
I like. I'm a fan of the koala myself.
They're nasty. Well, those things are nefarious little bastards.
Well,
I'll tell you right now.
And a story just came out about they kept koalas. They separated them by gender recently, doing some studies, and the girl koalas started just getting on each other.
Dirty girl
I swear
koalas.
To you, just came out like a week ago.
And actually, little known fact: when there's no snow in the southeast area of Australia, they actually grind up koalas and snowboard on those.
Really?
Yeah. Well, there's an abundance of them.
Tori, that's pretty cold right there.
Now I'm just coming up with lies.
No, but what's funny, Tori, is you're not the first member of the Bright family to compete in the Olympics, though. Your sister competed in 2002, right?
Yeah, she did, in ski racing.
Wow.
Oh, she's a two-planker.
Do you guys fight? Do you guys do gladiator wars as to who's better, snowboarders or skiers?
Well, no, because, it's an easy win with the snowboarding.
Totally. But, I thought you were going to say it's a
fit. I love skiing.
Do you?
And I still ski with my sister. It's awesome.
Really?
Yeah.
Excellent. a little cross training there.
Yeah, you could look at it that way.
Interesting.
Either that, or you could look at his total Benedict Arnold move. Traitor. Filthy traitor.
A Benedict Arnold.
Yeah.
I always like that reference towards traitors.
I did too.
Because he was a total traitor.
I know, but you got to ask yourself, does saying Benedict Arnold to an Australian mean anything to them?
Does it? Tor, do you even know who Benedict Arnold is?
I have no idea.
Okay, Revolutionary War guy. He was a traitor for the English. He was an American, I don't know what his rank was, but he was in the American, you know.
It's like a general or something.
Yeah, he was really high, and he was a traitor to the British. So when we say somebody's a traitor, they're Benedict Arnold.
Yeah.
So you learn something every day, even on useless radio talk shows like ours.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's all totally, totally useless. Awesome.
Winner X gold medalist Tora Bride here in the Extreme Scene. Where are you at right now? Where are you hanging out?
I am chilling at my house in Salt Lake City, Utah.
Oh.
And what are you wearing?
Oh.
We're going there. Might as well.
I told you. I gave you the option to opt out. I gave you 3 full seconds to say, I'm out of here.
It was true.
You stuck around, and now there's a certain professional obligation. You have to answer the questions.
It's true.
I won't lie to you. That's
well,
how it works.
I just got down from the hill, so.
So you're sweaty.
I'm sweaty.
Disheveled.
Yeah.
I have my snowboard pants on.
All right. You know what? Just leave it at that.
Okay.
Let the imagination of Steve go from there. We're all good.
You're on fire today.
I know. It's just rotten.
Well, I'll say this much to add to it. Now, you're a Roxy girl. Your main sponsor is Roxy, and I've never, ever witnessed a Roxy girl who is not just beautiful.
Absolutely true.
And on top of that, all the Roxy girls either wear hot pink or that baby blue.
I like the baby blue myself.
I mean, it's just that, Roxy just, they figured it out really early.
And they're talented and hot. Yes.
Winning
talented
combo.
And not hot, no sponsorship. Sorry.
You know, you walk into the office down there and everyone is amazing looking.
Yeah, but 93% of their makeup is actually plastic or silicone or
in LA.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I think Roxy's in Orange County.
Yeah.
But no, I mean, not taking anything away, you know. I like dolls as much as anybody, so.
Steve, you're just on fire today, man.
He is.
He's not this crazy usually.
Not usually.
Okay. I'm digging it.
I'm looking at some of your stats and how you finish over there. You seem to consistently finish at least on average within the top 5. So do you think your skills are growing? Where do you train at?
Mostly, well, it just depends really. But Utah is my base, so I ride here whenever I'm not traveling and competing.
We're in Utah, Park City,
Park City and Brighton.
There's a lot of you guys up there. I think Sean White trains there mostly.
Well, there's
there's so many people that have either been here for years or moving here.
Yeah,
right. Well, I think it's a lot to do with, first of all, you get really great quality snow up there. You've got a slew of different resorts around there, it seems to cater to it.
Yeah, you know, and there's an airport too, just 15 minutes out of the city, so it's
wow.
Yes, the giant flying contraptions. I've heard of them.
These flying machines, these crazy things.
Crazy.
I've heard about them. What lucky guy is dating you right now?
Yeah.
No lucky guy.
What?
What?
Huh? Why?
I'm a busy girl, you know.
You are
all over the place.
You are. That's true.
And boys are bad news.
Yeah, they are. One day.
One day. Boys are bad news, Tora. Wait, Tora, how old are you?
22, 23?
20 years old now.
You're just 20?
20.
Oh.
Yeah, stay away from the boys. They're nasty, they smell bad, and yeah, they're just not nice.
A lot of your teammates and fellow riders out there, especially in the pro circuit, are known to dabble occasionally in the party scene.
Right.
Just dabble.
Dabble.
Just you know, put your toes in.
A little bit here, a little, little pinch
little dabble,
there. A little pinch there, a little sprinkle there.
I mean, is the temptation there? I mean, are you really that strong-willed?
I made a decision that I just wasn't going to drink, and I think it was a good one because when I'm out, when everybody else is partying, they think I'm the drunkest one there, so.
Tor, do you surf? I mean, you are from Australia.
Yeah.
I am learning. I started last summer, and I am in love. I dream of it. It's so good.
Mm-hmm.
It is.
Tor, you're a delight. You're beautiful. You're talented. You're the whole package. We love you, and congrats on everything, and thanks again for coming on.
Thank you so much.
All right. Take care, Tora.
Okay, bye.
All right. Bye-bye.
And that was Tora Bride here in the Extreme Scene.